Oracle, or any other database. It's very similar. So let's say I have a data, same set of data means, when I'm saying this, let's say employee data, all the same number of columns, employee ID, first name, last name, blah, blah, blah. I am getting in 3 or 4 files. And then after that, I have to do some processing and put it into a single file or a database or something. So then I'll do the union. So union is something in which is I'm getting the same number of columns in the same order, but split it into maybe 3 or 4 files. Not files. Maybe one could be database, another one will be file. So those things I'll come in details, but let's do it first. Okay. So what I have done is I already have 3 files, employee 1, employee 2, employee 3. So what I did is I split that employee data into 3 files, employee 1, employee 2, and employee 3. Okay. So these are my 3 files. What I'm going to do is I'll create another file using union transformation. Now, since all of the 3 files have the same structure as employee, what I can do is I can just bring employees 3 times. Let's bring one more time and let's delete this. Okay. Now after that, my target is this one. I'll bring employee ID, full name, phone number, salary, and department ID. So let's do this. So I have already created this expression, I copied it, and I'm using it here again. Now I'll show you one other thing. So in real world, you will not see, like, this is a sample, so that's why you have so less number of ports, like maybe 10 to 12. In real world, you will be having like 25, 30, 50, 50 ports. So 50 ports, connecting 15 ports, 50 ports one by one is very tough. So quick way to do is select this one first, go to layout, auto link by name, I'll select this, drag and drop it here. So wherever the name matches, it will connect automatically. Okay. So now this is how my mapping looks. I have 3 sources connected to 3 expression. Now I'll create a union transformation. Okay, so if you look this union closely, you will see when I brought all those columns, it created three groups with the same name of the column and same kind of data type with the same order. So you see, you can see here I have three lines of input but only one output. This is how when you put the output field name, this is how you get the headers in a file, okay? source file is I have split the employee source file into three source files, employee 1, employee 2, and employee 3. So now if you look here, you see the source qualifier, one file has read 28 records, another file has read 24 records, another file has read 55 records. And in the target, I have 107 records. Why? What I have done is I have split the source files into three different files, and I have used union to again reunion them. Make sense? So if I go to my target files, okay, so this is what? Now in your target, you've got everything again. Now, few things important in the union transformation. If you want to take a note, you can take a note. One thing, number of columns have to be same for all the pipelines. Otherwise, you cannot do union. So let's say if this one has four columns coming in, I cannot do it. What I can do here is maybe, let's say if I do this thing, this is possible. This is possible where department number, department ID is connected from only one source and rest are not connected, then what you will get is you will get null values for the rest. So you are not creating correct values. So to get correct values, all the sources should have the same number of columns. First thing, put it on the text. Do it, what is the question? Okay, let me finish, then I'll come back to questions. So let me first finish, then I'll take all the question answers. So next thing is the order of the columns, right? So first here, if you see the order, so first column is my employee ID, second is full name, third is phone number, fourth is department. So this order has to be same. If the order is not same, then what it will happen is you'll see wrong data in wrong places. So this is important. Second thing is union is a heterogeneous transformation. So a heterogeneous transformation means, let's say I have tested this with one flat file, two flat file, and three flat files. But instead of flat files, let's say first one is Oracle, second one is DB2, third one is flat file, then also union will work. So union is very good in handling the heterogeneous sources. And one other thing I wanted to tell is, let me see, what is the question? Do it matter if the output is on employee 2 or employee 3? No, output is not in employee 2 or employee 3. The output is on the output file, which is my employee underscore union. So employee 2 and employee 3 are my source. It's not a target. So any questions on union transformation? Okay. Union, the purpose of union and the purpose of router are completely different. You have to understand this. Union is kind of same, let's take an example, okay? You went and let's say you want a new mobile connection from T-Mobile, and then one guy went to T-Mobile store, another guy went to Best Buy, another guy went to Walmart. Now for these three guys, T-Mobile will still ask the same information, like first name, last name, SSN, and address, blah, blah, blah. So what I'm trying to tell you is same kind of information is gathered in all the three places. But these three places are using three different systems. They are not using the same systems to gather the information. Now, when I want to put all my customer information into a single table, then what I have to do is I have to take the information from T-Mobile store, take the information from Best Buy, take the information from your Walmart, and then merge them together and put it into a single table, let's say customer table. So usually when we use the union transformation is most of the times when you are getting data from two or three different sources, and then you have to, but the processing of the data is same. So you collect the data from two or three different sources, then process them, union them, and then process them, and then put it into a target. That's the purpose of union. Now, router is completely different. Router is exactly doing the opposite thing. Router is you are getting the data from a single source, and then you want to distribute the data based on some condition. So if you look router, it will be like this would be your source, this would be your router, and these three are your target. So if you look into, see, if you look to my union transformation, I have only one output port, set of output ports, and three set of input ports. Now if you look to my router transformation, it's completely opposite. I have one set of input port and three set of output ports. So does that answer your question? So router cannot be used for sources. No, what do you mean by router cannot be used for sources? And then it doesn't mean that I cannot use router and union in the same mapping. If required, I can use both router and union in the same mapping. I'm getting the data from 10 different sources, I'm collecting them, doing a union, and then after that I'm putting the data into two or three different places. I can do that. Source file type option as direct and indirect. No, yeah, with the direct and indirect, we will take it later on, because indirect file method is a complete different thing. I'll tell that later on. Okay, so right now we are doing direct. So this is more or less all about your union transformation. Now today we'll see something different. That is, until now, whatever we have done is your everything from a file. Now today we'll see how to connect to a database and read the data from a database. Okay, so we will do the same we'll do this same exercise, reading data from a file. Okay, what is the question? Also, can we connect source directly to union transformation without expression? Yes, you can you can connect, but as I told you earlier, it's always best practice to put an expression transformation immediately after the source qualifier. Okay. So we will do this same exercise where I have a file from my sources are employees and my target is my employee underscore TGT. But this time the source will be my employee table from the HR schema. Now in the expression we have done something. If you look to my union expression, I have done this thing. I have done this first name concatenation, last name, and this phone number logic is there. Okay. So does this assignment use us? What is the question? Does this assignment use any interest? I don't remember, but what I can give you an assignment. That's not a problem. I can give you an assignment. Let me first finish this and then I'll give you, okay? Remind me at the end of the class. So before doing that, let me first see whether my HS schema is open or not. Okay, so my HS schema is open. So now to create the, to import the table from a database, I will use this thing, import from database. Now here I have already created, but let's do this. So you have to first create a ODBC connection. So this is how you create it. You go to system, non-administrator. Okay, I will select this one, the Data Direct 6.1 Oracle Web Protocol. Finish. I will give the data source name. You can put anything. So let's put HR underscore, let's say HR1, because I already have created HR, so let's put HR1. Host will be your local host. Port number will be your 1521. This is my ORCL. And let's do a test connection. Username is HR. Password is HR. Connection established. So I will do apply. Okay. What I will apply. Okay. Can someone try to do it parallelly with me, because I don't know why it's not showing me its test is, connection is established, but it's not allowing me. Why? Is anyone trying parallel with me? Maybe I do not have. Let's do it, create it then from driver. Okay, don't use system DSN, let's use user DSN and to create it. I think that's the way. So DSN name is HR1. Okay, yes, it's good. So now once you create the ODBC connection, then you select that one, whatever you created, and then you put a username password as HR. Once you connect it, you will see the tables in the HR schema. But before doing that, let me tell you one other thing. It is possible that your HR schema is not unlocked. So what you have to do is, first I want everyone to go here and do HR and see if you are able to connect or not. If not, then I'll tell you the commands how to unlock it. Or I can write it right here. Okay, what you do is before that you have to log in as DBA, so you will be logging like this, sys as sysdba, then you will put enter and password will be just enter, okay, and then you can write this.
So HR is an existing default schema already created?
No, HR is already created, it comes by default, so you have to unlock it. So what I'm going to do is I'll send this to everyone through chat window.
Okay.
So this is what you have to do to unlock the HR schema. Okay. But you have to log in as a sysdb, otherwise it will not allow you. If you have any problem in doing that, let me know. I'll help you. So once you connect to the HR schema, so HR user rather, you will be able to see all the tables in that user. So I am interested in employees. I'll click OK. And you will see, okay, you will see that employee, it has created another tab where you'll see employees. Okay. So now I'll create a new mapping called m_emp_db. I'll bring it as a source. I'll bring it as a target and Are you, Spandana, is your database is 12C? I'm not sure how it works with 12C because I have never used it. So can you just check, do some Google search and see how it works with 12C, if the schema is there or not. I will also do some search. Okay, thank you, Spandana. So I created this blueprint. Okay, now you have to understand one thing. This is just guys, hold on, my system actually turned off. I'm trying to start my system. Okay, I'm back. So what you have to understand is I have created an ODBC just to get the employee or employee structure from my Oracle database. So I have created, basically I created a kind of connection, ODBC connection, to get the structure of my employees table from HR schema. Okay. Now I am going to create the session. Okay, that is, let me do that first. So now I have to create, now to run the session actually, I have to create a okay, let's understand this. This is a, kind of like this. So let's say, think of a real-time scenario like you are, let's say you went to your, went to DMV office. Like most probably all the DMV offices are same. So you went to DMV office, you got a token number, right? But that token number does not tell you, and then there are like maybe 10 windows or 20 windows. That token number does not tell you that you will be going to which window, right? So that token number only tells you that, okay, you are in the queue, you will be given a chance to talk to somebody in the window. Now when this token appears on the screen, then you actually know that you have to go to which window, maybe window 6, window 7 or whatever. So this is a very similar to that kind of thing. So in Designer, what I've done is I have taken the token, right? Now in when I run the actual workflow, now workflow is something which is happening. So when I run the workflow, I have to run the workflow, I have to tell tell Informatica that you have to go to which window to do your transaction with DMV. So I have to tell him that you have to go to which window, otherwise he cannot do it. So similarly, in Informatica, I will create... Sorry? Is there something for me? So I have to create a connection to establish that window, to tell Informatica which window I have to go. So what I'm going to do is I'll create a connection here. So this is my relation connection. I'll tell this will be a relational connection and which database, this is my Oracle database. Create a new connection with Oracle database. So what I'm going to do is maybe I can give any name, but let's say I'll give some name through which I can, by reading the connection itself, I can easily understand where to go. And then my username is HR, my password is HR, my connection string is ORCL, and then click OK. Click OK, close. So now, when I'm creating the workflow, okay. It see here you see there is a place which says connection object. Now it tells me by default I have only one connection, Oracle HR. That's why it's going to Oracle HR. So let's say, let's do this. I'll create one same connection with a different name again. So let's say I created one more connection with another name. So let's say I create another connection, Oracle Scott, and my username is Scott and password is Tiger. ORCL. Close. Now when I'm creating this workflow, the interesting part is when I'm creating this workflow, you can see I have the option here to choose Scott or HR. So I decided that okay, my employees table is in actually in HR schema, so HR user, so I choose this one and then I finish. Now I disconnect this one and I will do employee DB. Now if you double click this one, if you go to source, here also you get a chance to change your schema. So if I decided no, I'll go with HR Oracle Scott. You can change your schema, like your connection, this is called connection string, so you can change your connection string here. Okay, now and my target, but target will be still the same. My target is still my Oracle output file. Let's take this one. I'm not explaining any transformation. I'm explaining how to connect to a database to read data. Okay. So then save, start workflow and see. Let's see what happens. See, you saw it's reading data from your source qualifier and then reading 107 records. If I go here, D PGT files. I'll look here so I can see the data. This is one thing. Second important thing is, if I go to my session log, you'll see here a few interesting things, like it will say, see, the reader is user HR, and this is the query which is fired by Oracle. Select employee ID, employees are first name, last name, phone number from employees. We will see the source qualifier transformation separately in another class, but this is I want to give you a preliminary idea about this. So important thing is, when you go to a real project, you will see thousands and thousands of connections here. Not thousands, maybe hundreds of connections here. Maybe few connections for Oracle, few for Sybase, few for Informix, DB2, depending upon what are the databases you are using. And whenever you have to read data from some source tables and rewrite data into some target tables, you have to know actually which connection to use. So what you can do is, you can ask somebody, like, which are the existing connection I have to use. Otherwise, you can create your own connection and do this thing. It's up to you. So what we have seen in with this work is how to read the data from a table and write the data into a file. Any questions now? No questions? Okay. If you do not have questions, let me give you a few assignments, which may be not in the list. One assignment is, I want you to create, okay, so let me write it down here. I want you to create a new schema for yourself. So you will be write something like create user, username, your name, and some new schema. So create a new user of your name. So this is first thing. Second thing is, create an empty table called EMP. This table will have the similar structure as employee. This table will have a similar structure like employees. Okay. Once done, don't create any primary key. So this is, don't create any primary key. Fifth one is, when do the same assignment, with target. Hold on for a minute. Let me first finish, then ask me the questions. Do the same assignment with target as table. Okay. Yes, ask me the question. What is the question? Question one is the schema or user. So it's same. User or schema, it's in Oracle, it's same. Schema slash user. So you will write something, create user, username.
Source will be flat file, the same employee?
No. Source will be your source. It will look like this. That's a good question. I should have put it. Charge. What is? So this is one assignment. This is very important because we will use this table later on few other assignments. So make sure you do this. Okay. This is one assignment. Another one, Rekha was asking regarding the union. So for union, because we have seen in union how to merge two files, now I want to use a union is. This is for union, okay. Source one will be your employees table, okay, and then after that filter data for DPT, let's say 60. So you read all the data from the employees table and filter the data for and pass data only for department number 60, right? And source 2 will be your employees file, okay? And you will read all the data and then filter the data for department, let's say 30, and after that use a union to merge them and put it into another file or table. Swati, the table connection is already, this video is recorded, right? So if you run the video, you can easily see that. After that, if you have any questions, please let me know. Because I will tell the same thing again. Now, any questions on these two assignments? Anyone who have not understood the assignment? Okay, that's good. Okay, so then this is what is expected before you come to the next class. Our next class is on Monday. So we don't have a class on Saturday, we don't have a class on Sunday, we have a class on Monday. You read this document. Hold on. You read this document. This is the one. So by now you should have read chapter. So these are the all chapters you should have read. Chapter 2, then chapter 7, chapter 9, chapter 16. No, sorry, 16 is not yet done. Okay. Chapter 21, chapter 22, chapter 23, chapter 24, chapter 30. Okay.
Did we do the router transformation before?
Yeah, router is done already.
Okay.
So read all these chapters so that you have some questions for me. On the top of that, I want you to do or try all the assignments, practice these videos. That's it.